a new car actually starts a lot earlier than people think it does. And the W10, our 2019 car, started actually in the dying months of 2017. The earliest parts of that new project are the chief designers of the power unit over in HPP and the chief designer of the chassis in Brackley getting together to set out what their aims and goals are for the new car, to try and figure out what the opportunities were to find performance that wasn't possible to build into the last one, but which we know would be difficult and long-winded, and therefore we got to start really early thinking about those things. So early work is the chief designers meeting and a group of very experienced engineers in both companies called the concept group that just try to weigh up lots of different options very, very roughly so that we can see the type of thing we might wish to bring to a new car. In the popular imagination, the winter is somehow quieter than the racing season. The truth is it's never quiet. The truth is it stays really busy throughout the whole year. You're conceiving and designing the new car during the racing season itself, and then the winter is the point of the year where all that starts to come together, where all the hardware is arriving at the factory, ready to be tested initially as individual components, then as sub-assemblies, then as major sub-assemblies, and then as a final car. But long before the hardware ever got to the car, there were design offices burning midnight oil, releasing hundreds of drawings a day, and production guys and planners and buyers just working frantically to try and get this huge volume of new material into the factory in time for it to be assembled up. And then once the hardware starts to pitch up in the factory, the torch is handed over to the people that build it, the people that test it, the groups that ensure that by the time we finally start turning a wheel on a track, that pretty much every part of the car has been fooled into thinking it's on a track and has done thousands of kilometers of running under the sort of loads and temperatures and fatigue cycles that it will see when it's being used in anger. The first fire-up is an interesting event because everyone can hear it. You've had a factory which has fallen silent for a few weeks from the end of the last season to this moment where an engine leaps into life in the factory again. And so even if you're not down in the build shop where the race team have assembled up with the help of others, the central core of the car, the hydraulic system, the fuel system, the cooling system, the chassis, the power unit, the transmission, they've assembled up the core of the car. It doesn't look much like a racing car yet. It looks a bit more like Arnie Schwarzenegger once you've torn all his skin off and you've just got the sort of Terminator beneath. It's the first point where you've got something that can actually leap into life. So everyone around the factory, even if they're not there, they hear it. And so it has a certain emotional impact on us because a motor is running in the factory. In the current world, the fire up of the car is about halfway through all of the sub-component testing work that gets you from first bit of hardware in the factory through to being at Melbourne ready to race. The car build period is a really busy time of Formula One team's life. The period that immediately preceded the build, which is the manufacture, is similarly difficult and busy, and the design that created that also, you know, loading the team to its hilt. It's a sort of phased thing where different parts of the team feel that pressure coming on their shoulders. They do their part and the next part of the team then picks up the load and carries on. The interesting thing is that the drivers throughout this period are both physically absent but ever present in this new car, because this is the time of year when we're building and preparing the car where the drivers are building and preparing themselves for the challenge that's to come in the next year. So although they're not physically present, the car itself is something which they have played a big part in, because every single track event that we've had over the preceding season. Every time that car has turned a wheel, in every practice session, in every qualifying, in every race, at the end of those sessions, the drivers sit with us and they tell us, corner by corner, lap by lap practically, what the car was doing, where it was strong, where it was weak, what they need to be different if they want to be better, if they want us to be better. And we write all those things down and we pore over them and we try to compile them into a picture that we can then build into this new car. So they're not physically present, but their voices are built into our program and our designs in a way that we hope when we start turning our wheels in Barcelona, they will pick up the car and they will see the way in which we've responded to the weaknesses and the strengths that were fed back to us over the previous year. Ahead of us, the two really key winter tests, but before that, the Shakedown. The Shakedown is a very limited number of kilometers that we get to do with the car ahead of those two winter tests. And the Shakedown is our first opportunity to find out whether everything we did in the factory has actually prepared a car that's capable of going around a track. And the Shakedown is our last opportunity, our last significant opportunity to make sure that the all-important 8 days of winter testing, just 8 days, that they are as useful to us as they can possibly be. And we don't want those 8 days interrupted by any form of problem that subtracts from our opportunities to maximize our track running. So the Shakedown is vital for us as the sort of final tick in the box to say, yep, good job everyone, we're ready to go in winter testing. And it is a shame in some ways that the critical nature of that hurdle, the are we ready part, overshadows to a degree the emotional impact of the fact that this is the very first time this brand new car, the recipient of so much love and attention, is actually on a track. And it's more, let's make sure that we've got everything ready, that we use those precious kilometers, and that we go home at the end of that solitary day, happy that we're ready for Barcelona. And it tends to be that the significance of the achievement, the bringing together of all those thousands of bits in harmony for the first time and going around a track, tends to be playing second fiddle to just the mechanics of let's make sure we're ready for the real thing, which is in a few days' time. But normally, by the time you're going to bed that night, if it went well and the relief has sort of washed over you at that point, there is time to reflect on the beautiful thing that has been created and to hope that that beautiful thing will be strong enough and have the sort of performance necessary to realize the hopes that have been invested in it.